Here we're going to solve this equation. We have 2x squared plus 8x plus 3 is equal to 0. And notice that this is the quadratic equation in the standard form, because we have ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So to solve a quadratic equation, we should first try this by factoring, right? But unfortunately, this is not factorable. So now we have two choices. The first one is we can use the quadratic formula to solve this. And the second one is we can try to solve this by completing the square. Well, in this video, I will show you guys how to use the quadratic formula to solve this equation. So let's first write down the a, b, c values. Right here, a is the number in front of the x squared, which we have the 2, okay? And then for b is the number in front of the x, which we have 8. And then for c, it's just the constant term, which is the 3. And in order for us to use the quadratic formula, of course, we have to know what the quadratic formula is, right? And we have to remember it really, really well. So it says x is equal to negative b plus minus square root, and then inside we have b squared and then minus 4ac. All this right here are inside of the square root. And this right here is on the top of the fraction. We have a big fraction bar. All over 2 times a. We have to remember this formula really, really well. It is a famous formula, right? And it has a lot of songs that can help you remember this formula. And now we just have to plug in all these values into this formula and then work it out, simplify, that's it. So we will have, this is equal to negative b, we know it's 8, so we can just put down the 8 right here. And then we have the plus minus, and then let's open the square root. We have b squared, b is 8, so let me put down a parenthesis, 8 inside, and then raise that to the second power. And then we have the minus 4, this is from the formula, okay? And for the a, we are going to be multiplying, so let's open the parenthesis, a is 2, so let's put down a 2 right here. And let me make the square root longer, because everything is supposed to be inside. And then we have one more right here. Let me open the parentheses. For the c is 3, so let's put down a 3 right here. And all this is all over 2 times a, so let me write down a 2. And then open the parentheses. For the a is this 2 right here. So this is the setup, and now we just have to work it out. So let's see, this is going to be negative 8 plus minus, and let me just open the square root first, right here. Well, we are going to work this out first, just the inside though, and you have choices. You can do this in your head, 8 squared minus 4 times 2 times 3, or you can write it down somewhere and work it out, or you can just put this on the calculator, and then, you know, just the inside and work it out.
I'm going to write this down on the side and show you how we are going to get that. 8 squared minus 4 times 2 times 3, okay? So let's work this out real fast. 8 squared is 8 times 8, which is going to be 64. And then 4 times 2 is 8, times 3 is 24. So let's put down 24, and this is the minus. 64 minus 24, this is going to give us 40.
And this is the number that will go inside of the square root, okay? So be sure you work out the inside somewhere on the side, and then put the result back. And this is all over 2 times 2, which is the 4. And now, are we done? What can we do more? Well, let's look at the square root of 40. Is there anything that we can do? Yes, let's take a look right here as well. Let me write down square root of 40. And to simplify the square root, we have to ask ourselves, what times what will be 40? And one of the numbers shall be a perfect square. We know 4 times 10 is 40. And 4, it's a perfect square, right? So I'm going to break down square root of 40 as square root of 4 times square root of 10. Square root of 4 times square root of 10, it is square root of 40. And by looking at this right here, we know square root of 4, it's actually just a nice number. This is just a regular 2, no more square root, right? It's a nice number. And then we maintain the square root of 10. We cannot do anything with it. 2 times square root of 10. And this is what I'm going to replace with the square root of 40 right here, okay? So let me just write this down here. We have negative 8 plus minus. This right here is the 2 square root of 10. Okay, I replace this with the square root of 40. And this is still all over the 4 that we have down below. And now what? Can we do anything? Can we cancel anything? Yes, because we have the 8 right here, right? And the 2 right here. Ignoring the sign, by the way. The 8 and the 2. We can factor out the 2. Be sure we factor so that we can cancel. So I'm going to do this right here for you guys. On the top, I'm just going to factor out a 2. So let me put down the 2 in the front and open a parenthesis. Originally, for the first part, we have negative 8, but then we factor out the 2, right? So we have a negative 4 left. And then we have the plus minus, we maintain that. And this 2, we factored it out already. So we just have the square root of 10 inside. And this is over 4. And now, this 2 times the parentheses, this 2 and this 4 can be reduced. We know 2 goes into 2 one time, and 2 goes into 4 two times. This is it. Final answer is going to be 1 times this, which is just that, right? Negative 4, and then we have the plus minus square root of 10. All over, so be sure you have the all over the 2 in the denominator. This is the most that we can do. Do not do anything else. Do not reduce the 2 and the 4, okay? Do not reduce the 2 and then the 10. This is it.